The prodigal son returns.
Well, you know, I didn't quite, you know, go.
I got it. I'm happy to see you, Elliot. Come on. I want you to meet some very, very groovy people.
You gave them the hash brownies?
They told me you said I should.
How many?
Four each.
Elliot! My baby!
Baby!
My little baby! My filthy baby boy! Give mama some of that dirt!
Hey, you!
So, Dmitri, music made such a difference in the Woodstock era. I'm wondering, was there a defining moment in your life where you felt music made a difference?
Yeah, that's a really good question. I love music. It's not going out on a limb there, a lot of people do. But when I first discovered the Beatles, again, they're probably not that hard to discover, but I never really listened to the Beatles as a kid. And when I was in my 20s, I started listening to the Beatles. And there was a period there, and I still always go back to the Beatles, but they were just like such an inspiring, like special thing to me, because they changed so much and they grew so much as a group and as artists. And it was, in the end, a very short period of time. By the time you get to like Rubber Soul, and then of course into Sgt. Pepper's and all the late Beatles stuff, it's just like amazing. Revolver, I think Strawberry Fields for some reason, it's very like emotional to me. I don't know why. I wasn't alive in the 60s. I don't know any of those guys personally, obviously. But just John Lennon's kind of voice and the depth that that guy had, it never fails to like do something for me, you know. Pretty cool.
Did you get to see Paul McCartney at Citi Field?
No, I hope I get to see Paul McCartney someday. I'm really such a huge Beatles fan. It's so awesome.
Now, what about being a hippie? Do you share any of that lifestyle? Would you like to embrace that?
Yeah, I like to think that I would. I think there's something very romantic about the idea of being a hippie and hippie culture. I like the idea of being open and thinking about something that's bigger than yourself, you know what I mean? At the same time, I have a lot of food allergies and I'm kind of like medically a little bit not the most robust guy. I mean, I'm not sick or anything, it's just that I can't eat certain foods, and if I do, my throat swells up and the whole thing. So I'm always worried, like if I go to like any kind of a place that I can't read the ingredients on things.
So a commune would not work.
A commune is hard for me. I'd be like the anal guy at the commune. Like if I were at Woodstock, I'd have to have like special bags of food like for each day and be like, I'm okay. Are there nuts in that? There's peanuts in that. I can't have the granola, I'm sorry, but I have my own. And I couldn't share then, because if I shared with too many people, they'd eat all my stuff. Kind of a lame situation.
So the hippie life would not work for you.
No. I like it, but yeah.
Tell me about that scene where you take the acid going on that trip. So how did you sort of channel that feeling?
That was tricky. Aang hasn't done acid. At least he said he hasn't, I believe him. I haven't done acid. Many people in that crew right there had not done acid. But there's a guy named David Silver who was the historian on the set. And I think he had, or at least he knew a lot about it for sure. So he was there right next to Aang, and we were kind of all consulting. He was giving us a lot of ideas about what happens when you do that. I think that's a real testament to Aang's direction there, that his cinematography and Eric, the DP cinematography, did a lot of the work for that acid trip. I had to just commit and really try to focus on my breathing and be present, but the cool thing is the camera turns, so it's what I'm seeing. So that's not really my performance, it's just the camera and Aang's kind of performance, which was cool.
I just found out that there is still acid in the world, which I am amazed about.
Yeah, that's crazy. It's just such a crazy thing that you put a little piece of paper on your tongue and it can do that to your brain. That's crazy. That's pretty powerful.
I mean, you're a comedian, so yeah. You probably don't even need drugs to, you know, just be who you are.
Yeah, I love daydreaming. I like drawing and daydreaming, and it kind of takes me somewhere else. I don't need drugs so much.
Tell me what your next project is.
My next project, well, I did a television show for Comedy Central last year, and I'm doing a second season of that show now. I just started writing that. I'm rewriting a movie that I wrote for Paramount, and hopefully that'll get made next year. And
what's that called?
It's called Will. It's cool. I think it'll be a good film. I'd love it if it actually happened. And I was supposed to be in this movie Moneyball that got kind of shut down, but it might come back. So if I'm lucky, I'll be in Moneyball.
Great. Well, great cool. performance.
Thank you. Thanks so much. Great to meet you.
You too.
Thanks.
Thank you.